A very good morning. I'm Dr. Neha Dubey from SIRT College, Department of MBA. Today I'm going to discuss the topic of introduction and the nature of a research methodology. So what is research? Research is defined as a careful consideration of a study regarding a particular concern or a problem using the scientific methods. According to American sociologist Earl Robert Baby, research is a systematic inquiry to describe, explain, predict, and control the observed phenomenon. It involves inductive and the deductive methods. We can say that research is a systematic way to find the solution of a particular problem. So what is the reasons or what are the purpose behind doing the research? Identify the potential and the new customer. It provides us the space or the scope for finding out the new customers and the potential market. Understanding the existing customers, the needs or the requirement of existing customers can be done with the help of a research or through the feedback forms. Set the pragmatic goals. It will be helpful for deciding the realistic goal which can be achievable. Develop the productive market strategy. Address the business challenges, put together a business expansion plan, and identify the new business opportunities. So these are the some purpose of doing a research. There are the certain nature of the research. Research is a systematic and scientific. Research is a systematic and scientific search for the pertinent information on a specific topic. Generally, research has to be follow a certain structural process. Without a proper steps or a proper structural process, we cannot move to the next step until and unless the first step should not be completed. Research has the objectivity. Research is quite objective in its approach and is almost free from the biases, prejudices, and the subjectivity. Research has a definiteness, means it is already fixed. It is characterized by the definiteness in its process as well as a product. Here are the modes and the measures for the collection and organizing the information or the data, and after that the testing and the verifying the collected information for arriving at the conclusion are all well planned and definite. It is already pre-planned or prefixed so that the each and every step should be followed in a proper manner. Research has a verifiability. Research lays emphasis on the proper verification of the collected information, data, or the facts. Here, nothing is accepted and derived unless verified through the adequate observation, test, and the experimentation. So, it means this topic means that the research lays giving the information importance to the verification part. When the collect information or the data can be collected, so it can be authenticate or the verified with the proper test, experimentation, or the observation. After that, we can say that it is authenticate now. Research has the predictability. The results obtained through the scientific methods are characterized with the ability of predicting the future outcomes of the things or the events. In a given situation, under the known circumstances, what would happen to a person, object, or the phenomenon can be reasonably predicted through the properly derived conclusions or result of a scientific procedures. So it is always based on the predictions. For example, in the normally elections, the voting polls or voting with the help of a voting polls researchers, we are predicting who will be going to win that election. It is based on the predictions only. Research has the modifiability and the dynamicity. As the world is totally uncertain, so there is a requirement of always the modifiability. Means the conclusion reached or the results obtained through the research are never final, absolute, and the static. They are always open to verification, observation, and experimentation. So consequently, what is true today in terms of the derived fact or the reached generalization may be proved wrong tomorrow based on the new findings. So therefore, research neither advocates rigidity in the process adopted for discovering the facts nor stands in a way of bringing desired modifications and changes in the pre-established principle, laws or the theories. There is always possibility of changes so that the situation as per the situation, so that the situation will be changed, so the results can be improved with the modification in established research. So, and the, what are the objectives of the research methodology? To gain the first one is the exploratory or the formulated research studies to gain the familiarity with the unknown phenomenon, or to explore the unknown object or the phenomena, or to achieve new insight into it is termed as the exploratory or the formulated research. To portray accurately characteristics of a particular individual, situation or unknown as a descriptive research means, in the exploring purpose, what we are doing, we are exploring the things, okay, or the objects. We allowed the researchers to develop the theories and explain the questions of how and why a phenomenon operates in a particular way. So this is called the exploratory or the formulative one. And what done in the descriptive way? Descriptive, for example, a researcher can describe the behavior of smokers by either observing it or analyzing their behavior by undergoing some standard test, like the measuring level of a resistance or the per day consumption. So what we are doing here is to portray the accurately the characteristics of a particular individuals or the situation. So this is done on the basis of the descriptive research. Now the next is that to determine the frequency with which something occurs or with which it is associated with something else are known as the diagnostic research. Means, for example, when we have a certain problem in our body, so we move to the doctor and he suggested some tests or on the basis of that system. So what, and after the report came, so he diagnosed the problem and they give the medicine to us for curing ourselves. So what is this? This is the diagnostic kind of a research. To test a hypothesis of a causal relationship between the variables known as the hypothesis testing research. Here, the cause and effect type of a relationship can be established between the variables. Means something is happened and the reason behind of that happening is known as the causal relationship between the variables type of a relationship. For example, here we can give example for understanding this phenomena. Like, do weekend parties for employee families improve the work-life balance? Okay, so weekend party is what? In this case, the weekend parties is the cause and the effect is a work-life balance. Means weekend parties will be the cause. On that basis, the result is what, or the impact is what? The work-life balance. Okay. And now the next one is that to predict the future activities. As I told the previous example of this elections, so we have to predict the future activities. Okay. And to influence the activities. Influencing the activities is the last one. And what is that? The researcher will be conduct this type of a study in a social, behavioral or the educational kind of a research in this. Means the things is influenced on the area. Okay. So this is the objectives of a research methodology. So thank you. This is from my side for today's lecture. We will meet you very soon with the next topic. So thank you. Have a nice day.